So quick assets is nothing but it will actually indicate the capacity of the firm, whether it can pay its current liabilities without selling the inventory or looking for additional financial resources to pay its current debt. So we have already calculated the current liabilities. I will simply write it over here as 16,000. I don't have to do the sum again because you already done that once. The quick assets will be nothing but the sum of the cash, which is this, and the debtors, right? So I'll simply say equal to cash is 2800. Again, the numbers are less, so I'm going to just write plus sign. I can easily use the sum function as well. 2800 plus 7000, which is coming out to be your 9800. The quick ratio is nothing but the division of 9800 by 16,000. Let me highlight this as well with a color, and we can easily use this color for the heading. Right, so we got quick ratio again. It's a positive number. It will be positive, but it's a bit less, which we can make out from the ratio also that the current quick assets are on the lesser side than the current liabilities. That means it might be very risky for any bank or for any other organization to lend a loan to this particular firm. It's not that risky, but certainly it is a bit risky considering the lesser side of the quick ratio, which is 0.6125. It's not that less also, but it's not that high as well. So maybe the company, it's at the discretion of the company whether they would want to lend the short-term debt to this company or not. The next ratio, very important ratio we have as debt equity ratio, which is nothing but the division of debt by the equity. And that is a very important reason being often people have to make a decision with respect to how much debt to take from a bank and how much equity to raise from the market. Certainly, both have their own obligations of a kind, because loan you have to repay it back in the monetary terms, and there and then it will have certain conditions and criteria. But yes, when it comes to equity, then also you have an obligation towards the equity holders because they have given you their hard-earned money. So you have the obligation to return that money back to them with the higher rate of return. And once if the shareholders don't get higher rate of return, certainly next time they don't prefer to invest their money in your company. And similarly, in case of a bank, if you do a default, if you have taken a huge debt and again you are not able to repay that on time, certainly it affects your image. So I suppose both are important parameters. So and often company just can't go with one component. They will have to go with both the components of debt as well as equity, but they need to take the call in what ratio they are going to take it. So normally companies prefer to have the debt ratio as 60-40 or maybe 30-70, depending on their discretion and depending on many other factors, right? Because if the I think it also depends on the interest rate that is prevailing in the bank. And also the easy loan options which are there in the bank. So the options are not that easier for the entrepreneurs to avail a loan. They might prefer to go for equity, but certainly they just can't have the whole equity or the whole loan. So they will have to make out a balance between the two entities and then take the call that how much loan they want to take and how much equity they want to have in case of a any project. The debt equity ratio is nothing but the, as I told you, it's nothing but the ratio of the debt by equity. So debt is nothing but the outsider's fund. If I just name that, it can be also termed as the overall debt that you have taken. So I name it as outsider's fund and divide it by the shareholder's fund. The shareholder's fund basically means your both equity as well as your preferential share. So outsider's fund is nothing but the, if I just see outsiders, it comes out to be debentures only. We haven't taken any loan as of now. It's not shown in the liability. We only have a debenture. The debentures is 1,000. So I just write 1,000 over here. And shareholder fund is nothing but the sum of your equity as well as preference shareholders, which is your प्लस वो 10,000, तो आएगा 15,000 प्लस 2,000, right? So let me just highlight this as well so that we know what we are doing. So let me highlight this with the other color, and we can actually make a difference between the entities taken for current ratio and for the other ratios. So we have outsiders fund as 1,000 and shareholders fund as 17,000. So I simply divide this by 1,000 by 17,000. I get the ratio as 0.05, which is a fair enough ratio calculated as of now. So maybe, you know, the company can take the call, you know, it's on a better side because the debt is low. And that means we have lesser liability on the company's side to repay it back to the bank or to the, any other company from where we have taken up the loan. So let me just highlight that in the different color so that we can understand that. Right, so I hope these ratios are very easy to understand. We have to simply divide, but we must be able to select the right entity from the balance sheet, because often people get confused what will come under the asset side or the liability side, or what will actually be coming under the debtor side or the maybe bills payable or can be paid. So the point is that even though we are not talking about from the financial perspective, but we must be very clear about the financial terms that we have to use in Excel. Because in Excel, maybe the aim is to only make a worksheet for these particular items. But certainly as a user, I must be knowing the meaning of these terms that I'm using. So the next ratio which I have with me today is the proprietor ratio, which is nothing but the ratio of the shareholders fund and the total assets. So total assets we have simply calculated, and this is nothing but your 34,000. And we simply write it over here, 34,000. Let me highlight this. It is already highlighted, but let me highlight with a different color so that we can differentiate this. Right, so shareholders fund is nothing, that also is calculated, it is nothing but 17,000, which was nothing, the sum of equity share as well as the preference share. And then we have the proprietary ratio, which is nothing but 17,000 divided by 34,000. And this is also on a roughly on the fair side, it's 0.5, not so high, not so less. So still, I think overall the company has a quite stable financial position with respect to these items. Let me just highlight that with a different color so that we can understand that and make out a better meaning of these terms. Okay. The next ratio which we have today with us is about the fixed asset ratio, which is nothing but your ratio of fixed assets by the long-term funds, right? So yes. Let me just write that and then I will do the calculation. Fixed assets ratio, which is nothing but the ratio of the fixed assets. Now in this case, we must be clear about what do you mean by fixed assets. And then we have the total long-term funds. The long-term funds, basically, if you remember, will be nothing but the summation of your equity share, your preference share, and your debenture. So I simply write it over here. Equity share is 15,000 plus 2,000 and plus your debenture as well, which is 1,000. Let me highlight the debenture also, because now it has also come under the category of the calculation. The fixed assets, that is nothing but your plant and machinery and land and building, which is going to remain fixed for at least long time to come. Because you don't plan to change your building and machinery quite often as you change the other entity. So let me just highlight this also with a different color. So let me use the green color over here. I have over here sum of 8,000 plus 9,000. So the fixed asset ratio will be nothing but the ratio of 17,000 divided by 18,000. So here again, it is coming out to be, it's on a higher side, 0.944. It means that the company indeed is endowed with good fixed assets, which it can rely on just in case if the company goes into loss or in the recession time, right? So this is all about the ratio analysis, and I hope I'm pretty clear with the today's class, and we can calculate the other ratios as well. And let me highlight that, and let me just make it more systematic. So ratio analysis, I remember, I just repeat, it's nothing, let me summarize that. So it's nothing but just a term to highlight the financial position of any company with respect to the total assets, the assets or liabilities, whether they're total or quick or current, and also the amount of debt that the company has taken, maybe from the bank or from any other company, and also the kind of shares or whether it's equity or preference share that the company is having. So overall, we see that the ratios, more or less, they are on the higher side. The first one, current ratio, is 1.0625. Next is the quick ratio, which is 0.6, which is also on a fair side. It's not that bad, but certainly not that good as well, because certainly we want to have the higher number because that is what we want. Debt equity ratio is 0.05, which is a bit on the lower side, and proprietary ratio is 0.5, fixed asset ratio is 0.944. Right, so all these ratios can be analyzed, can be interpreted further to understand the financial position of this company, Unicorn Limited. That is all for the day. Do leave your comment for the class, and let me know what else we can do.